Now we're going to bend our right knee and hold onto the right. And we extend the left leg forward. We're going to work a little bit on our core. So now we release back. You lift the heel and the toes stay on the ground. And you release back. You can go, let's go first just over the sacrum plate. And then come up again. And you just check, okay, is that even flowing or connect to which core muscles it's going? Keep your arms straight if you can. When you come up, let a little wave of lengthening go through your spine. And then go back again. Exhaling, rolling back. Inhaling forward. And lengthening the spine. That's maybe the degree you want to go today. If you want to go a little bit further, go lower until you feel, oh, this is where the lower rib ring would start, and then you come up again. And really most important is that you can develop an even flow down and an even flow up. And even there, where the direction changed from backward to forward, you want to have an even flow. Then you know all the muscles that are meant to work in this one are working. If you want to go further, I just say, because I see some of you are going really smoothly and they have the potential to go all the way down and all the way up, do so too. Five more. Don't go too far and feel, oh, now I sneaked up and I came out of my even flow, because that means you never will train the muscles that need to come in action for the even flow up and down. And I see that you work with that straight leg, really active. That's perfect. Very good. You can even imagine that the heel of your straight leg is pushing into the ground. Beautiful. Next time when you're up, keep even flowing. Change sides. And you start with the little ones. Just over the sacrum plate. It seems a small way, but it's quite a lot of core engagement. And when you are ready and you want to go further down, you just keep going. Long breath. Last one. Good. normally when we have right and left, there is no middle, hey? And some people say, luckily there is no middle, but here we have two legs. So let's do it with two legs. And you hold your hands onto your knees and you roll back over your sacrum plate and you come back up. And then you experience how with that long leg, we have a counterweight, isn't it? It makes it a little bit easier. So now when you come up, work with both legs really strongly into the mats to counteract. And then keep going and see whether you want to come a little bit further down and whether it's smooth, how much you have to work with these legs to be that counteract on that seesaw. Go three more and go to your deepest. When you come up, it sometimes helps if you bring your legs, let's say you are on this stage, and you pull them a little bit slightly forward, like 10 centimeters. That just makes the leverage of the legs, a little bit more use of the leverage of your legs. Fantastic, very good. Next time when you are down, stay there. Finally, on the back. Bring your knees out into your elbow creases, hands in a mudra. And then rock from side to side and feel now when you move first the knees, the hips, vertebra by vertebra, and just see how far you can go to the side without clumping. Another very subtle work for our core that we don't fall to the side. There is a lot of holding there that you just smoothly transition back to the other side. It's also a beautiful massage for our spine, a beautiful twisting, little twist, and just feel how far do you sense that twist going up along your spine. Back at center. Exhaling, partial decline, lower both feet down to the ground, arms to the side. Bring your arms up, facing up towards the ceiling. Imagine you want to stick some stickers towards the roof. So curl your chin in, lift your shoulders, your arms, and your hands are reaching straight up. They don't reach through to the knees, they reach straight up. And then relax again. Feel the vertebrae between the shoulder blades. Relax your head slowly. Now you go inhaling up and exhaling down. So it's, you all do really well, not going forward to the knees. It's really up towards the ceiling. So we target the upper muscles in our core, the ones who hold the lower ribs in. Make sure that your neck is not tensing. And if you feel, oh, my neck is really tensing, have one hand underneath your head to support the head. Still going straight up. Last one. Relax. feet met with a pad, forearms holding. Exhaling, bring your knees towards the right, shoulders to the left. Inhaling, change sides, knees towards the left, elbows to the right. Mm-hmm. And just feel when our knees and elbows meeting in the middle at the right at the same time, or is one part of your body quicker? Beautiful. Now, if you want to add the head, turn the head with your knees. If you want to at the eyes, turn the eyes with the elbows. So head and knees go to the same side, and elbows and eyes go to the same side. If you master all four, you are really good. Back at center, knees to chest. Exhaling, partial decline. Lift your hips and place your hands underneath your body. Raise your heels, bring both knees up, and extend your legs up. Now, exhaling, lower your right leg down, and then inhaling, lift your leg up. Alternate sides. If it's too much with the straight leg, bend your knee and extend. And then bend your knee and extend it up again. Just feel, if you have lower back issues, bend your knee, extend your leg, bend your knee again, and then straighten your leg up. If your lower back is fine, you can go with single leg lifting up and lowering it down. Now feel the core work, holding your lower back into the mat. Beautiful. Next time, if you have done your left side, lift your hips to release your hands. Bend your knees and bring your knees out to the side. For spider, holding on to your pinky toe side of your feet, if you can reach, or to your ankle, back of the knee. Now, allow your sacrum plate to be on the ground. Feel that's a really important alignment here, sacrum plate on the ground. And you maybe feel when you have the sacrum plate on the ground that your lumbar spine is in a slight curve. So that means we hold the natural S-curve in our spine in that pose. let the breath flow. And if you feel like you want to rock from side to side, do so. Fantastic. Back at center. Keep your legs as they are, bended, maybe a little bit more together, hands next to your buttocks. Now push with your hands into the floor and lift your buttocks a little bit up. Last core work here. Push with your hands into the floor, lift your buttocks, lift your knees, and release back down. And same here, how even flowing can we go? If there is a lot of momentum, you're not quite there to use the right muscles. It's okay, but just know that you are working more towards even lifting buttocks, sacrum plate, first vertebrae of the lumbar spine, and depending how far you can go. Five more. Keep smiling with your heart, with your face. Last one. Knees to chest. Check in whether you have created some tension in your neck. If so, rotate your head a bit from side to side. Jaws relaxed. Your next exhalation, partial recline. Feet hip width apart, close to the buttocks, parallel. Knees parallel, thighs parallel. Inhaling, tuck the tailbone, roll vertebra by vertebra up into bridge. And exhaling, roll vertebra by vertebra down. And so just repeat. Sense, are you giving each vertebra same attention? Most likely we have areas in our spine that feel numb, or even blind spots. Try to detect them so we can spread our awareness evenly through our spine. Go slow over the blind spots or the numb spots. Maybe even hold for a breath there and breathe into that area. Next time when you are there in bridge pose, hold bridge asana. For today, let's hold with our muscular strength. Feel your grounding down with the feet, with the shoulders. You have two opportunities with your arms. You can interlace the hands underneath and move your shoulder blades more together, or just keep your arms parallel. Feel the back of your body holding strong. Your buttocks, your back muscles, they work towards the front of the body. They reach up. Fantastic. Feel there is stillness in the pose. let all mental noises and clutter also flow out. Find the stillness in your mind too. Exhaling, release. Let the shoulder blades glide out. Release your hands, feel vertebra by vertebra releasing. Have a deep breath in, partial recline. Arms T, extend your left leg forward. Shift your hips towards the right and twist with your knee towards the left. Hip side stretch. So the hip moves a little bit towards the resort and the knee then twists to the ocean. If you don't feel a twist, most likely you need to move your hip a little bit more towards the resort. And then feel, are the shoulders grounded, both shoulder blades? And sometimes if you push with your left elbow into the floor and lift slightly, you can ground both shoulders a little bit better. Make sure your neck is relaxed, your face is relaxed. Go back to the expansive exhalation and inhalation. Exhaling, unwind. Knees to chest. Arms T, feet partial recline. Now extend the right leg. Ground your left foot into the mat. That helps to lift the hips and to move the hips more to the left. And then twist with your knee, with your hips to the right. Check in with your shoulder girdle. Is the shoulder girdle on the ground? Sometimes pushing with the right, on this side, with the right elbow into the mat helps to ground both shoulders a little bit better. Feel head either straight up or to the left. Exhaling back to center. Final knees to chest.